Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. Infowarsstore.com.
Welcome back. Now, joining us tonight from Genesis Communications is Ted Anderson, but of course, he's also the head of Midas Resources. And so we want to talk to him tonight about gold. Welcome, Ted.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you. Now, there's been a lot in the news lately. Going back just to April of this year, we had the Oklahoma legislature reaffirm gold and silver as money. In other words, reaffirming our Constitution, right? But the interesting thing to me about that is that they're now not going to tax, as far as Oklahoma income tax, they're not going to tax the exchange of gold and silver because it's a currency rather than a commodity as far as they're looking at it. But there's also some other interesting breaking news that we've had. Just 5 days ago, we had some transcripts, and we're going to play a little bit of this and let you respond to it. Alan Greenspan talking to the Council on Foreign Relations about gold. And basically, he sounds like a gold bug. So we want to talk about that. But then in 7 days, actually, no, 17 days, the end of this month, there's going to be a referendum in Switzerland where they're going to vote as to whether they're going to back their currency again with gold. And I think that's a key thing we need to talk about is how they use these fiat currencies to manipulate the economy, to manipulate us just like they do with interest rates. But let's talk first about why they're demonizing gold in public and then in private, they're accumulating it. Let's go to one of these clips from Greenspan. I'll let you respond to this.
Gold is a currency. It is still, by all evidences, the premier currency where no fiat currency, including the dollar, can match it.
All right, so he says it's a currency, a premier currency, and the dollar can't even match it. What do you make of that?
Well, Greenspan, of course, has been a gold bug and was when he was in college and then became sort of an elitist when he became the central bank, in charge of the central bank of the United States, the Federal Reserve Bank. But the reason why he's saying that is because we have been in this currency war with other countries. We resort to spending and inflating our currency, pushing the value of our currency down against foreign countries to try to expand on our exports and increase our economy. Of course, foreign countries have to also react to that, deflating their currency value as well. And it's this constant currency war that goes on. And so Alan Greenspan's looking at this whole game being played, and he's just saying, hey, there's nothing that you can do that matches gold in these foreign countries or in the United States with the paper currencies. The reason being is because we can't maintain control of supply versus demand for products, goods, and services. The GDP doesn't go up in relationship to the expansion of currency. Therefore, the currency loses purchasing power. Greenspan says, hey, gold is a fixed supply. You can only pull so much out of the ground. It's been money for thousands of years. They found it in King Tut's tomb. They didn't find U.S. dollar in King Tut's tomb. So obviously, gold is going to be much more valuable in the future as long as these central banks keep playing games like they do.
You know, listening to this CFR presentation that Greenspan gave, he sounds like Ron Paul. He even goes back over the history of gold to some extent, goes back to World War II and talks about its intrinsic value and how you could see that at the end of World War II with Germany. Let's listen to this clip.
Intrinsic currencies like gold and silver, for example, are acceptable without a third party guarantee. And I mean, for example, at the end of World War II or just at the end of it, Germany could not import goods without payment in gold. The person who shipped the goods in would accept the gold and didn't care if there's any credit extended associated with it.
All right, so that's a very important aspect of gold, that it's not somebody else's debt. It's got intrinsic value. That's what he was essentially talking about. That's why the Nazis were forced to use it, because nobody was going to take their paper money, right?
Well, exactly. I mean, if you think about it, Dave, I mean, World War II was obviously preceded by World War I, and the currency, just the Weimar Republic note, just turned into, you know, basically toilet paper. Or, you know, it was more valuable to trade a wheelbarrow than it would be a wheelbarrow full of money. When a currency loses purchasing power, gold in itself becomes more valuable. And the reason why they wouldn't take the country's currency is because the currency may not have held no value overseas or anywhere. Gold, like Greenspan says, in it itself is value. It has no attachment to anybody's debt or anybody's ability to pay. It is money.
And we've seen that. Everybody knows about the Weimar Republic as an example, people showing up with a wheelbarrow full of paper notes to buy a loaf of bread. But of course, we've seen that in many other countries, haven't we? We've seen super hyperinflation in many other countries in Africa and South America and other places, haven't we?
Precisely. And that's exactly why people need to get into gold and silver both. Silver is a much more smaller form, easier to trade for smaller items. Gold is a store of wealth that can be used portable in much larger sums of money, obviously. But yeah, indeed, if you're looking at any of these second and third world countries, and now we're even concerned about the United States, gold and silver simply makes sense.
Let's take one more quote from Greenspan. I want to get your response to that.
Why do central banks put money into an asset which has no rate of return, but cost of storage and insurance and everything else like that? Why are they doing that? If you look at the data, with a very few exceptions, all of the developed countries have gold reserves. Why?
So basically, he's asking the same questions that an individual investor would ask. If there's no rate of return on the gold, if I have to pay to store it, if I have to pay to insure it, why would I do it? And yet, all of the central banks in the developing countries are doing that. Why are the people in the know doing that, even though they're not seeing a rate of return on it, so, per se?
Well, first of all, you have to ask yourself a question, why do I need a rate of return? And the reason is because if I hold my money in paper currency, I know I'm going to lose through inflation. Mm-hmm. Someday in the future, I'll have to pay more for goods than I have to today. So just to keep up, I have to have a rate of return. With precious metals being a commodity, it simply rises along with all the rest of the commodities. If I have to pay more for oil, chances are I'm going to have to pay more for gold, because it's not so much that oil and gold is going up in value, it's the value of the currency that's dropping. So we need to have a rate of return. And then you're talking about why do central banks in the world, why do countries hold stockpiles and reserves of gold and silver? Because of the fact that it is money, and it means money more than their currency means money. And they can see the wars that are going on. When they know that they have to devaluate their currency in order to keep up with the country across the street, so to speak, in competition with their products that they're producing, they need to have something that's real solid that they can fall back on. Countries trade with each other with gold. Individuals trade with each other with currency. I don't know why we've been sold this bill of goods and why we accept it, but this is how it happens.
Now, one of the things I want to go to is this change in the Oklahoma bill that's been passed, the change in the way they're going to treat gold in terms of right now. And to put it in an analogy, if you sell your home after a number of years, let's say that you're in a home for 20, 30 years, and you sell that home, it's going to have a paper value, a value in American dollars. It's going to be maybe 10, 20 times as much as it was when you got it. And yet we know that it hasn't really gone up in value that much. What you're just seeing is it's valuation in terms of paper money. And so when they're taxing you when you exchange gold at this time, what they're doing is they're kind of taxing you on how they're manipulating the fiat currency, aren't they? But that's going to change in Oklahoma. Talk about that, how that's going to change
Sure.
for Oklahoma investors. Maybe other people can do that in their states.
Well, this is very similar to what Kurt Bills put a bill through in Minnesota, which did not pass, but Oklahoma's adopting this. And we also seen the same thing in Utah. It's more about if we're trading currency amongst each other, we don't charge a sales tax. If I give you a dollar, you don't have to pay sales tax on that dollar. The sales tax on gold, you do have to pay in many of the states right now. So one of the ways to get around having to charge sales tax for a purchase of gold and silver is if the state itself remonetizes the gold. And now when they call it currency, you no longer have a sales tax involved. And so several of the states in the United States have gotten away from charging sales tax because they look at the purchase of a gold and silver coin as an investment rather than a consumable, if you will. Mm-hmm. You're buying it for resale, for later resale. That's typically why you don't charge sales tax, because you're looking to resell it in the future. In this particular case, Oklahoma is looking at getting more towards purchasing gold and silver without having to charge sales tax, because so many people have to go outside of the state to buy the gold and silver. Happens in Minnesota. Texas happens to be a place where you can buy gold and silver without having sales tax to a certain degree after you overreach a certain amount. California was one of the very first states to adopt this policy. But to remonetize is a great way to say it, because gold and silver is money. There's no reason in the world why there should be sales tax associated with the purchase of gold and silver.
And this is actually going to extend to the Oklahoma income tax, the taxable income portion of it. Just like we were talking about before, if you bought a house in the 70s and the median price of a house was maybe $20,000 and you sell it today at $200,000, that's just a reflection of the loss of purchasing power of the paper money. It doesn't mean that you've had an appreciation of $180,000. We're seeing that with gold and silver all the time as well. Hopefully there's going to be some bills passed in multiple states that are going to do this. I know they're trying to work one through in Arizona. It passed the House, but it hasn't cleared the Senate yet. One last question. Let's take a look at what's going to happen 17 days from now in Switzerland. It looks like they're going to go back and perhaps they want to get gold repatriated. They want their Swiss bank to hold it, not foreign banks. We've seen that movement in several different countries now. Germany has done the same thing. But the Swiss also want to take it one step further. Up until 2000, they used to have gold backing their currency up to 40%. They want to at least get back to half of that, to 20%. So it's going to be interesting to see that referendum. What do you think? It seems like the Swiss people are awake.
Well, and obviously the Swiss are very conservative, mm-hmm. but the reason why they want to get back to gold is because of the fact that their currency is going to become much more stronger than all the countries around them. And the Swiss have always been a country that has been solid, fiscally responsible. They're watching all these countries around them fall apart. They don't want that to happen to them. They back their currency with gold. All of a sudden, people want the Swiss currency rather than the euro or something else.
That's great. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. It's really been interesting. It's going to be interesting to see as people are waking up and we have even former chairs of the Federal Reserve talking about how there's nothing else quite like gold.
Well, it certainly tells you that you should be getting into gold if Alan Greenspan, the chair of the Federal Reserve right. system, is doing it. So there
that's
you go.
Right. He's accumulating it, so that's a pretty good recommendation. Well, that's it for tonight. If you're watching this on YouTube, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. And if you're not a subscriber to Prison Planet TV, please consider that, supporting our operation. You'll be able to share that with 11 people. They can watch the news as it's happening each night, and you'll have access to all of Alex Jones's documentaries. We'll be back Monday through Friday, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern.
Celebrate the spirit of freedom and liberty upon which our nation was founded at InfowarsShop.com. Molon Lave is ancient Greek for come and take it. This popular design combines both classic Greek Spartan imagery with modern M16 assault rifles. Now available in women's tees and proudly made in the USA. Celebrate the spirit of 1776 with the George Washington brass belt buckle or this incredibly sharp looking 1776 hat. Badass. And be sure to check out the new arrivals at InfoWars Life, where you can prepare your body to perform at peak levels with Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine, Super Male Vitality, and Fluoride Shield. And wake up, America. Immune Support Blend is the healthy choice for the gourmet coffee lover. So get incredibly high-quality, freedom-based products and help fund the revolution at InfoWarsShop.com.